afternoon student. In the previous video, you all have learned about the resources. Today we will start a new topic, classification of resources. Before starting this, let me rewind you about the resources. Resource is a supply of something, a piece of equipment, etc. that is available from somebody to use. In simple word, we can say that a resource is something that can be used for a purpose. For example, like tools and materials are resources. Now we come to our topic, classification of resources. Natural resources, first of all, the classification of resources, in which include the 3E type: natural resources, man-made resources, and the human resources. And natural resources are the contribution. First, let me write down the three types. You can write it here that resources are generally classified into three types. Resources are generally classified into three types. First one is the natural resource. Second one, you can write it, it is the natural resource, the man-made. Man-made resource and human resource. These are the three types of resources. First, we come to the natural resources. Natural resources are the contribution of nature. Whatever exists in nature and is usable by man is termed as the natural resources. Like the air we breathe, the water we drink, and the animals and the plant around us, which you use for our needs, and the materials we use to manufacture things, all are natural resources. So you can write the examples also. First, you write the definition of natural resources, that we the resources that we got from the nature. Natural resources. A natural resources is what people can use, which come from the natural environment. Environment. You can also give one or two example here, like the air, water, iron, etc. Okay. Now we come to the type of natural resources. Natural resources are classified into different group depending upon their level of development and uses, origin, stocks, and distribution. So you can write it the types also, or that types of natural resources. It can be classified into different group, to different group depending upon their level of development. not only that development, you can write also O, level of development and uses. And use. The origin, stock and distribution. And distribution. Now we first come to the first point, that is on the basis of their origin. So here it is written, on the basis of their origin, natural resources can be divided into two main category. The first one is the biotic resources and the second one is the abiotic resource. You can write also the part here that it is divided into two parts. It divided into two category. Into two categories, biotic and abiotic resources and abiotic resources. Children, you know what is biotic and abiotic resources? Biotic resources are the substance obtained from living beings and abiotic resources are the non-living substance. So, first we come to the biotic resources. You can write here the first point, it is the biotic resources. Biotic resources are the substance obtained from living beings. You can write here, it obtains substance from the living being. Substances. From living being. You can give here two or three examples also, like the vegetation, bird, domestic animals and the wild animal. Everything within the biosphere which has some utility for man is a biotic resources. Vegetation can give rise to economic activities like the forestry and lumbering, pastoral farmings and agriculture. Animal and fishes can be used for the livestock raising, dairy farming, etc. So these all are the biotic resources. You can write here some examples also. Give some examples like the vegetations, bird, domestic animal, etc. Up to here, children, it is clear. If you have any confusion, you can query with me. Now, up to here, it is completed. In the next video, I will explain you about the abiotic resources. Thank you, class.